himself seriously. Rodel Rose had lost their punch for him. He opened all his bags. There were two, and inside those two, there were two more. It's not an easy situation. But there was something like abandon in the air. There was something like the feeling of the idea of some scars in the air. There was a kind of madness to it, the kind we read about in magazines. The bags contained a bottle of liquor, a sure sign of thoughtfulness about who one might have been. He poured himself a small drink in a fluted plastic glass sans ice. He thought to himself, if I were from the Big Ten, they would be calm and debonair. The Big Ten doesn't sell its riffraff out. He sat up in bed, both feet on the floor. He studied the ashtray, trying to rule out preference, preferring over not preferring. How do you prefer gravity over what other state? Preferring in that case, Earth, the Earth as they say, preferring some state over non-state. Now he grips himself with determination, even knowing that it causes sadness. He is determined to be one. He is determined to be serious. He had determined once to be serious. Later he knew that he had made a mistake, but too late he had arrived and there were rooms and all rooms were not the same. Some better than others, he thought. A better view, a better layout, better shower, softer bed, not so far from noise, more like home, etc., etc. Very abstract. He lifted the telephone from its cradle. His determination got stronger, if not clearer, even as he faded in its force. Were it not for our momentum, the inertia of our actions, the constant inspiration of our habits, we could not continue. There was almost nothing, he thought to himself. At the sound of the first ring, he hung up. He pushed down the button, listened to the silence of the object in his ear, and then he hung up. Very dramatic. So